From the Sierra Nevada Mountains just outside of Granada, Spain, is the women's slalom race here at the 27th Winter Universiad. Temperature today, minus 10 degrees. We've had some up and down temperatures throughout the week here in the mountains. A couple days just a little bit above 0 Celsius, but a lot of days right in around where we are today, about minus 10, minus 12. First up, it is Thea Grosvold of Norway. This is her first run of two. The combined time will be used to rank the skiers. She finished 36th in the Super G back on February 6th here at Universiad, but then did not finish the giant slalom. There you see the time to beat, Paquin Ricard of Canada, and Grosvold will do it quite easily, over 7 seconds ahead to move into first place. Now it is Eve Routier of Canada. She was fifth after her first run in the giant slalom, but then did not finish her second run. You get a good wide angle view there of her working her way down the course. And at the interval, just a little bit ahead of Grosvold. There's the time to beat through the final gates and 4/100ths back. So she'll move into second spot, a good run for the Canadian. Now back up top, this is Monica Huebner of Germany. She skis for the University of Denver in the United States. You can see that on her helmet. Coming up to the interval. She'll be 15/100ths of a second behind the leader, Grosvold. Carving well through these gates. And as she makes her way to the finish line, time to beat. Still not beaten. 35/100ths back of Grosvold. Now it is Catherine Auer, Austrian skier. Earlier in the week, she did not finish in the giant slalom. So trying to have a better result here today. A little bit behind at the interval. Slalom, the most technical of the races. You can see her now just at the line, and she will move into first place. 27/100ths ahead of Grosvold. And there you have the leaders after the first run. It is Auer in first, followed by Grosvold and Routier. Now to Huebner. She was fourth after the opening run. She's from Garmisch-Partenkirchen, which of course was the site of the 1936 Winter Olympic Games. She did not finish in the giant slalom here earlier in the week at Universiad. So trying to improve on her time of 49.12 in the opening run. Working her way down here to the finish line. And she will move into first place, at least temporarily, 46/100ths ahead of Kachenko of Russia. Now it's Routier of Canada. Third after the first run. Just a little bit back there at the interval. She's from Université Laval in Canada and was fourth at last year's Canadian National Championships in the slalom. Carving well, keeping good speed down the hill. Comes over that final crest and towards the finish line. Will she have enough to beat Huebner? No, just in behind, 14/100ths back of the German. Now it's Grosvold, second after the opening run. Time of 48.77 seconds. She too skis in the United States for the University of Colorado and was 19th in the slalom back at Universiad in Trentino in 2013. Good speed here through the gates. And over that final crest to the final few gates. Makes those turns. And she will move into first place just ahead of Monica Huebner. She likes that run a lot. And now Catherine Auer, our leader after the first run. With a time of 48.50. Behind, though, of Grossvold here right now. A little bit out of control through that gate, and can she control it? No, she'll get past the gate, but basically came to a dead stop. So Auer, our leader after the first run, gonna make her way down the course, but she's going to finish well back. You see it there, almost 4 seconds back. And there's the celebration. Thea Grossvold of Norway, the gold medalist in women's slalom, followed by Monica Huebner of Germany with silver, and Eve Routier of Canada takes the bronze medal.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student-athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.